One of the men accused in the 2007 Ajmer blast case had alleged that several union ministers and senior Congress leaders and also the NI officers had pressurized him to implicate senior RSS leaders. And this explosive claim is sparking a huge controversy, with the RSS claiming a conspiracy and demanding a thorough investigation now into all these charges.
This whole investigation has become a big conspiracy against RSS and its leadership. There have been alleged attempts to mislead the entire process of investigation by powers that be, especially some important people in the government. This has been our stand from the beginning. There was a deliberate conspiracy to implicate certain senior RSS leaders. Now things are coming out one by one. There's a need for a genuine and thorough investigation into all these things that are coming out. But the fact remains that this whole investigation into so-called saffron Hindu terror, these are the words that they use, smacks of a lot of political conspiracy.
Congress is also coming forward and rubbishing these charges, backed by the NI, who claims that the accused had recorded a statement before the magistrate and there is no question of pressurizing anyone.
I have never met or never seen who is Bhavesh Patel. The very fact that he has claimed to be a Sangh activist, the very fact that he has also stated in his statement given to the court that he was a part of the Ajmer bomb blast, it proves my earlier statement and point that Sangh has been involved in bomb blasts in this country. Now, as far as this is concerned, I would say that the NIA should also investigate that after making a 164 under section 164 a statement before the court, he has come out with a letter. What I have gathered from my own sources, and I have got fairly good sources, which you may kindly agree, that his statement which he has released, first of all, who has released it? Whether NIA has released it or it has come to the media? That's another point which I am trying to make. And his statement is not in his handwriting, but his signature is genuine.